Hello, everyone. Welcome to the Professor Messer CompTIA N10-006 Network Plus training course. This is a complete video training course that is available for you to watch from the very beginning to the very end, where you'll learn everything you need to know to pass your CompTIA Network Plus exam. This is an exam that was released in February 28th of 2015. And generally, CompTIA updates these exams about every 3 years. So check your watch, and if this is about 3 years after that point, there is probably a newer exam available for you. In the meantime, the N10-006 is the latest in the Network Plus certification series. I've designed these videos as small bite-sized topics, so you should be able to find a topic you're interested in viewing, and there's generally a 10 to 15 minute video that helps describe that particular topic. Then if you have time, you can watch another one, or you can go do something else and come back at any time. There's no long time commitment to get the information you need to pass this exam. I also wanted to create a very high-quality training course, not only in the video and the audio, but I wanted the content to be of very high quality. I have a background in both IT and in training, so I've combined those two to create this complete Network Plus course. The goal is to have as many people as possible certified on what I feel is a very, very important set of topics, which is networking. All of these network topics will apply no matter what you do in technology. And so this will be a foundation of knowledge that you can use throughout your IT career. It seems like there should be some catch to this, but there really isn't. I've taken every minute of every video and made them available online. You don't have to register. There's nothing special you have to do. You can, from anywhere on the internet, connect and watch any of my videos. If you would like to have a video to take offline with you, I do provide those for sale. You can find out more about those on the Professor Messer website. I've also taken all of the graphics, all of the tables, and the displays from my videos, and I've made them available in a series of course notes. And that's another thing that you could purchase directly from the Professor Messer website. The main certification video index for all of these is always maintained on my website as well. So if you'd like a one-stop shop to take you down the entire list of videos, you can find them all on professormesser.com. The Network Plus certification is provided by CompTIA. CompTIA is the largest provider of vendor-neutral IT certifications in the world. They're also the organization that provides the A-Plus certification, the Security-Plus certification, and many others. These certifications used to be managed and maintained by individual companies. If you needed an IBM certification, you would go to IBM to get those certs. If you wanted a Dell certification, you would go to Dell to get those certifications. And instead, all of these companies have become members of CompTIA, and there's now a centralized series of certifications that is all managed from one central place. CompTIA manages this across many organizations around the world. In fact, there's a footprint in over 100 countries where you can get your CompTIA certification. And if you're non-English speaking and you'd like to get a certification that's in your local language, there's probably a CompTIA certification that's written for you. The CompTIA certifications are some of the most recognized in the world. These are very popular certifications. And Network Plus is a very good foundational certification to have. Whether you're working with databases or data center administration or server administration or operating systems, they're all going to connect to the network. So the more you know about networking, the better you're going to be in any part of information technology. Many organizations require that you have a CompTIA certification. The federal government in the United States, for instance, requires a certain type of certification level depending on where you are in IT. So it's not unusual for companies to require you to go out and get one of these certs. But even if they don't, you're still going to have that personal knowledge and satisfaction of knowing this information, and it will undoubtedly help you wherever you go in IT. Let's look at the details of the Network Plus N10-006 exam. You may also see this listed or written as the JK0023. This is exactly the same exam, but it's one that is provided from CompTIA Academy partners, and they use a different numbering scheme if you're taking your exam through one of their partners. This is a 90-minute exam, and you may get a maximum of 90 questions, which means you may also be asked fewer than 90 questions on your exam. To pass the Network Plus exam, you need to get a 720. The scale here is a little bit different than exams you may have seen in the past. CompTIA uses a scale from 100 to 900. And although they don't share the specifics of how they grade their exam, we believe that each question is worth a different number of points. So keep that in mind as you're trying to determine how many questions you need to get right to pass your exam. That may be difficult to calculate. You will get both multiple choice questions where you choose A, B, C, or D. But now CompTIA will also ask you questions that they call performance-based questions. These may be questions that are fill-in-the-blank or matching, or they may put you at a command prompt and ask you to perform a particular task. The Network Plus exam covers a broad number of topics. You can see all of the different domains are listed here. Network architecture is 22% of the exam. Network operations is 20%. Network security is 18%. There's an emphasis in network security on the Network Plus exam. Troubleshooting is 24% of the exam, the largest of the domains. And the industry standards, practices, and network theory consists of 15% of the exam. There are a number of best practices you should consider when you're planning to take your exam. The first thing you should do is go to CompTIA's website and download the exam objectives. CompTIA provides a very detailed list of objectives, so if you're trying to determine if a particular topic is covered on the exam, the answer is going to be inside of those certification objectives. You should also watch these videos. I've created an entire course, and I've covered every single topic from those certification objectives. So if CompTIA says it's in the exam, then it's also going to be in my videos. There's also a book you may want to consider from GTS Learning, which has integrated my videos directly into the book. So as you're reading through a particular topic, you'll also find my video right next to it so that you can get additional reinforcement on that particular subject. You may want to also discuss these questions you have with other IT professionals. So on my website, I have an online chat and forums that you can participate in, and I have a monthly study group. If you go to the Professor Messer website, there's a calendar link that will tell you the next time that we're going to do our live Q&A with Network Plus. Once you've done all of this studying, the taking of the exam should be the easiest part for you. But before you schedule your exam, you might want to stop by the testing centers in your area and make sure that you're going to be taking your test in a place that's comfortable for you. The quality of testing centers can vary somewhat, so it's nice to be able to know exactly what you're going to walk into. Then make sure you get plenty of sleep, that you're able to get a good meal, and that you're in a comfortable place when you go in to take this exam. If I have to provide my best tip, it would be to go early and get on site. There's usually a lot of nervousness and anxiousness involved with taking an exam, and once I'm there, I'm able to settle down before actually walking into the testing center. The testing centers are designed with a quiet, comfortable place to take your exam. But if there's any problems with the environment or noise or anything else in the testing center, make sure you stop right then and address those with the folks at the testing center. You want to be able to solve those problems immediately and not wait until the exam is over. The Network Plus exam is 90 minutes long, and you'll probably get somewhere close to 90 questions. So time management is going to be very important. Make sure when you're going through the exam that if you get to a very difficult question or you feel it's going to take a long time to answer, you may want to consider marking that question and coming back to it later. Unlike a number of industry exams, the Network Plus allows you to jump around to any question at any time. So you could go through the entire exam, mark a number of questions, and the final screen will give you a summary view that shows you which questions you answered and what their answer was, and it tells you if you marked any of those, and then you can jump back to that question very quickly and answer it. Before you submit, make sure you've got time left to check through all of these answers and make sure you've answered every single question on the exam. We don't believe there's a penalty for wrong answers, so you might as well guess instead of leaving something blank. And then check to see if you passed. You'll know immediately when you click the submit button if you got a passing score or not. And if you didn't, don't leave without the printout that shows you how you did on the exam. That way you'll know what to study so that you can come back and take the exam and pass it the second time. I've worked hard to take practical experience and put it into the certification course. Seems I've done almost anything in the IT industry they asked me to do. Everything from operations to training to engineering, networking, security. And I want to take that knowledge and provide it to you in the form of these videos. And of course, I also have my A+ and Network Plus and Security Plus certifications as well. So when I talk about the exam experience, you know you're hearing it from someone who's taken those exams as well. So let's get started. If you want a good book, you can go out to the Professor Messer website /GTS Learning and get the GTS Learning book. You can also, of course, visit the Professor Messer website for the complete index of the Network Plus videos. I've also got message boards on my website and forums that you can participate in. You may need to register for those. There's no cost associated with them, and there's no private areas. Everybody gets to share with everyone else on the website. On every page of my site is a real-time chat, so if you have a question at any time of the day, there's usually someone else there who can help you out with something that you may need. And of course, you can send me a message directly. You can go to the Professor Messer website, and right at the top is a Contact Us link that tells you all of the different ways to get in touch with me. Well, hopefully this has given you an overview of the Network Plus certification and the things you need to know when you're starting your path towards getting this IT certification. I think networking is one of the most exciting things in IT, and I think you're really going to enjoy learning this information. We'll see you on the website. Good studies.